What did I do to deserve this? That's a question that is posed both in positive situations and negative situations. If something bad has happened, that we get fired, or that there's some illness that we've been diagnosed with, what did I do to deserve it, we might ask. On the other hand, if we receive something totally unsolicited, and it's not our birthday, it's not Christmas, some type of praise is given, we're kind of suspicious at times and say, well, what did I do to deserve that? We always think there has to be a cause and effect. I know that in my own family, I do have a nephew, Liam. He's now a teenager. But when he was a little boy, my brother, whose name is Bill, every time he saw Liam, he would give him a dollar bill. I said, why do you do that? He says, I'm just trying to help him learn my name, Bill. So I said to my brother, if you give me a 20 every time you see me, I'll tutor Liam. Make sure he remembers who you are. But that idea of getting something for nothing is hard to comprehend at times. And that's what we hear, both in the second reading and in the gospel, that God has loved us, not because of anything that we have done, not because we deserve it or earned it. It's totally free. And that's sometimes hard for us to comprehend. We have this ethic that says we have to earn it. We have to work for it. And God says to us, no, you don't. I love all of you just because of who you are. We heard in the chapter of John that we read that God so loved the world that he gave his only son so that anyone might be saved through him. We're approaching the great mystery of Easter, which reminds us through the Triduum of God's great love for us. The key to the spiritual life really is to respond to the love, to accept the love, and then to live in such a way that we really truly believe that we are loved. And once we believe that we're loved, then we really do live in a certain way. Lent is really the time to reflect on that free gift and the response that we're making, maybe positively and negatively, to that love. Lent is a time to be aware of what one writer calls the encore sins in our life. Those things that come back over and over and over again. It's an encore. It could be the lack of patience or the lack of respect or a sense of dishonesty or selfishness, lying, whatever it is. We all have them to one degree or another. Those things that are just simply part of us and we don't always make the effort to rid ourselves of that, to change the vice to a virtue, to patience, to honesty, to respect, whatever it might be. Today really marks the halfway point of Lent. If we've been working on things of prayer, penance, and acts of charity, great. Don't lose heart. Continue. If we haven't done anything for Lent, there is still the whole second half of the time period to do something, to introduce into our lives some type of greater sensitivity to our prayer life, maybe acts of penance, and also acts of charity or love. We've done nothing to deserve God's love, but we try to live out our response, because what we are is God's gift to us, and what we become is our gift to God.